With many MCU actors reaching the end of their multi-picture deals, we might be saying final goodbyes in Avengers Endgame. No relationship between old and new cast members has been as deep or as touching as the one between Tony Stark and Peter Parker. We know that Peter comes back after the snap, but what remains to be seen is what kind of reunion he'll have with Stark and how long it'll last. Let's take a look at some possibilities. Peter Parker's been a part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe before he was even allowed in the MCU through the magic of the retcon when it was added to the canon that it was actually young Peter Parker in that Iron Man costume that helped out Tony Stark when he was fighting hammer drones in Iron Man 2. Since then, the two characters have been tied together in the MCU. In Captain America Civil War, Spider-Man Homecoming, and Avengers Infinity War, the pair are inseparable. That is, until the snap happened. We know that our snapped out heroes will make a comeback, but the nature of that comeback might color the kind of reunion we get for Parker and Stark. The effect of Thanos' ambition in the aftermath of the snap are gonna leave an indelible mark on both survivors and those brought back. For Stark, stranded in space with only the single-minded revenge machine Nebula as a companion, we know that he'll spend at least the early parts of the movie desperate to find a way home. It stands to reason that he'll find his way back, whether it's by hitching a ride with Captain Marvel, welding something with Nebula, or maybe even Pepper Potts' rescue, saving Tony a second time. Tony's bound to rejoin Earth's mightiest heroes for the final fight. We don't quite know what that fight may be, but after all the long-suffering Pepper Potts has been through, she might be able to convince a weary Tony Stark to give up the suit for real this time. Tony's pending retirement has been a subject between Potts and Stark since Iron Man 3. Stark false-started a retirement again at the end of Age of Ultron. Before Ebony Maw and Cull Obsidian showed up in a Q-ship looking for Doctor Strange's necklace, Potts was pressing Tony about the nature of retirement if he was still carrying that suit on his chest. If Tony's able to see his young protege return along with the rest of Earth's heroes snapped back into existence, he might take that as a sign he's finally able to hang up his iron spurs. That would mean that before riding off into the sunset for a second time with Pepper, this time leaving the Iron Man behind for good, he could have that one last one-on-one with his protege to let him know that he has what it takes to take on the threats of the world, but not to forget the people close to him. It'd be a powerful moment for the young hero with such intense ties to his own family, and might even be the reason Parker initially decides to leave his suit behind on his trip to Europe. Of course, you can't have an Avengers movie without at least a little tragedy. While Coulson's death didn't quite keep, his stabbing at the hands of Loki motivated the quarreling heroes to come together and fight for mankind against Loki and the Chitauri. Quicksilver's sudden introduction and sudden death was a rallying point in Age of Ultron, and of course, Infinity War was stacked with tragedy. While we expect some of the tragedy to be undone, there's bound to be a little more tragedy before the credits roll in Avengers Endgame. One of those tragic moments might be the end of the first member of the MCU. Since the beginning, when Tony was willing to take a nuclear bomb on a supposedly one-way trip to outer space to end the Chitauri invasion, Stark has been willing to make the big sacrifices to save the Earth. It's how he ended up hitching a ride on the Q-ship to Titan in the first place. It may come to pass that Tony finds himself having to make another big sacrifice at the end of Endgame to bring the fallen heroes back to life. He said before that he'd be responsible for anything that happened to Parker, only to have him dust away in his arms. Should the choice come along, Stark would trade his own life for the lives of those he feel he let down. This would make the reunion rather bittersweet, wouldn't it? Especially if a revived Peter Parker comes back just in time to say goodbye to his former mentor. It'd be an inversion of the final moments of Infinity War and a way for Stark to pass the torch. Not only would it be a good parallel scene, it also fits nicely with the theme of Spider-Man's existence. Spider-Man's a character that's built on a pile of tragedy. It's not just the loss of his Uncle Ben that it turns out he could have prevented, but also characters like Gwen Stacy that he couldn't save, or friends like Harry Osborn, or mentors like Dr. Kurt Connors that he can't prevent from turning evil. Parker's motivated by a duty to the tragedies in his own life. Having his mentor in the MCU sacrifice himself to bring him back to the universe is exactly the kind of weight that Peter Parker would carry for the rest of his life, while also being a fitting farewell to the first member of the MCU. Of course, this all supposes that the unsnappening happens by the end of Endgame. The Russo brothers have said that they can't show anything in the trailers except for the first 20 minutes of the movie, which might mean that the snap is undone far earlier in the movie, and the newly reassembled heroes must face a new threat or an enraged Thanos. This also means that Spider-Man and Iron Man might actually meet earlier than we even thought, and even might have a chance to fight side by side against whatever threat manages to manifest itself. If there's one way to out epic the team-ups that have happened one right after the other in Infinity War, this would be it. We've been told that there's a scene with everyone in it one place, and that's widely assumed to be the unsnappening itself. If that's the start of the battle instead of the end of a movie-long quest, it might be a sight to behold. This would give young Parker one more chance to impress his mentor and even perhaps see Tony sacrifice himself for his young protege. If that's the case, it leans back into the tragedy that drives Spider-Man, as well as giving the pair a final chance to join each other fighting for the safety of the planet. It also means that Spider-Man can have his final moments with Tony Stark while still allowing for Tony's even more final moments to be with the long-suffering Pepper Potts. While we do want to see the young hero and his mentor have a moment together before the end, audiences who have followed the Stark-Potts romance since the first film in 2008 would probably like to see the journey of those characters end together. There is another way for all of this to come to an end that doesn't involve the tragedy of Tony Stark sacrificing himself, but still motivates a young and impressionable Peter Parker. Follow us on this. Tony Stark might take a page out of the director of S.H.I.E.L.D.'s playbook and simply disappear. Not in a cloud of dust, but in the cloud of war instead. When Nick Fury was facing the realization that S.H.I.E.L.D. was being infiltrated by the nefarious organization Hydra, he allowed an attempt on his life to appear completely effective, meaning that even Captain America thought he had passed on. Since that time, Fury has only shown up sparsely here and there to nudge Earth's mightiest heroes in the right direction when they seem lost or when the team could really use a helicarrier. When handing S.H.I.E.L.D. over to the not-dead Coulson and the whole power struggle that happened in his wake, Fury has been quietly working behind the scenes with plans that only he knows in full. Thanks to the Spider-Man Far From Home trailer, we know that Nick Fury returns to his hero recruiting ways when he knocks out Ned Leeds and asks Spider-Man to assist him in the Mysterio problem. In a world that has Tony Stark in it, there might always be a lingering demand for an Iron Man. It's possible that after three or four attempts to retire, Tony sees the only way to be with Pepper and not Iron Man is to disappear. Of course, disappearing is a lot easier for an international super spy than it is for a genius billionaire philanthropist playboy. But with all the technology and genius at Stark's fingertips, and likely the grateful assistance of what's left of S.H.I.E.L.D., it might be possible for Tony Stark to vanish, allowing the long-suffering Pepper Potts to have Tony all to herself. Maybe they go off and do charity work together without armored suits or fighting alien invaders? Or their new pals, the Guardians of the Galaxy, could set the duo up on another planet where the advanced technology might actually provide a challenge for Stark. Either way, this allows the Marvel Cinematic Universe to say a soft goodbye to Iron Man and open the door for the new heroes like Captain Marvel, Black Panther, and of course, Spider-Man to take the center stage in the MCU. If Robert Downey Jr. and the House of the Mouse decide at a later point to have an Iron Man cameo or for old Shellhead to make a comeback at a key moment in some future MCU event, they wouldn't have to go through the whole bother of resurrection like they did with Coulson or Bucky, but simply have him pop back up in the same way that Nick Fury has when the time is right. This doesn't mean that Tony and Peter won't get their heart-to-heart, all the torch-passing and responsibility-bearing will still get to happen between the two, but with the added pressure that somewhere, somehow, Tony Stark would be watching and could come back at any moment and push the protege back on track. There's a line that fans have parsed over and over again in the Far From Home trailer that suggests that Parker's on his own now. While there are a ton of clues that point in a ton of different directions, this one might suggest the possibility that there's a Tony Stark, but he's not taking any calls. We could be seeing Peter Parker taking in exactly how gone Tony Stark is. For the most part, fans have assumed that this is someone telling him Tony Stark's dead and that there's no one else. But it could also be someone telling him that Stark meant it when he said he was leaving. Of course, Pepper Potts still signs the giant check, so she might not exactly disappear with Tony. That'd make his departure bittersweet for both Peter and Pepper. However, the reunion and inevitable re-separation will be a big moment for Parker, who hasn't had the best track record when it comes to mentors. This relationship with Tony Stark isn't as deep in the comics, where the two have been teammates, but not nearly as close as they are in the MCU. Though he does at one point when reassembling the Avengers offer the one thing the perennially cash-strapped hero needs most, a paycheck, the relationship has been more front and center in the MCU. At best, the people important in his life tend to hate Spider-Man. People like J. Jonah Jameson or his lovable Aunt May. In the Far From Home trailer, we do see that MCU's Aunt May has learned to support her nephew's alter ego, and maybe has a little bit of a romance brewing with the affable Happy Hogan. But it's the relationship with Stark that Parker's been missing ever since that fatal bullet took away his uncle, who gave him that legendary piece of advice, that with great power comes great responsibility. Or as the MCU Parker puts it, if you can do something and you don't, what happens is also your fault. But you can't have Spider-Man without a fair amount of tragedy, and the Marvel Cinematic Universe has miles to go and more heroes to take their turn in the spotlight. Iron Man is bound to bow out and take that retirement from defending the Earth at some point, whether it's through sacrifice or simply stepping down. However it happens, it's likely to take a toll on the young hero and shape him in a way that, while different, will be consistent with the kind of hero that Spider-Man is. Either way, we look forward to finding all of this out when Endgame hits theaters. These are the most likely scenarios for the inevitable reunion and departure of Spider-Man and Iron Man. What do you think will happen? How do you think Peter Parker will say goodbye to Tony Stark? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe to CBR for more MCU content. Thanks for watching.